Hello, and welcome to the next dSPACE Innovation Coffee Break. My name is Martin Brühl. I'm Senior Product Manager at dSPACE, and I'm responsible for the so-called ZIL testing business field.
Hi, my name is Gernot. I'm a field application engineer here at dSPACE, and I will take care of the demos today.
Yeah, and today we will demonstrate you what is meant with software-in-the-loop testing. So let's assume you're a software engineer at a car manufacturing company. You have developed a new software function, and now you want to test it. So what options do you have? Of course, you can flash the new function in your test car, drive around, and test your new function in the real world. Another option is to connect the electronic control unit to a simulator that simulates your car. This is then called hardware-in-the-loop testing. But wouldn't it be more convenient to test your software without using any hardware at all? So in this case, you can save cost and time because you can simulate several tests in parallel. You can run your simulation faster or slower in real time, or even step by step for debugging if necessary. And you can start testing even before the ECU is available in real hardware. So this is the idea of ZIL testing. So what steps have to be done to get your ZIL environment running? As we said, you want to test your software that is running on a real ECU, but you want to test it without having the real hardware available. So let's put the software components you want to test to a virtual component, a virtual ECU. And to get that running later on in the ZIL environment, we have to add or adapt some other components that are really dependent on the hardware. And dependent on what you want to test, there are several options available, several abstraction layers possible for such a virtual ECU. For example, you can just use the application layer where your algorithm is in, or you can use additional basic software components if you want to test, for example, the communication between several ECUs. The next step is to use this virtual ECU and let it run on an offline simulator, for example, the tool wheels from dSPACE. And to close the loop now, you have to put additional components in that simulation, for example, a vehicle simulation or traffic simulation, put everything together, and then you have a software-in-the-loop test environment. And as we said, this has additional benefits. You can just use a standard PC, you're very flexible in your simulation time, you can start tests in parallel, and so on. Gernot, I think we have such an example running on your laptop, right?
Yes, thank you, Martin. Indeed, I prepared something. But first, I'd like to say showing software-in-the-loop simulation isn't as easy as you might think. The core component, VEOS, is silently running in the background. So what I will show instead is what magic you can do with it here. We've prepared several virtual ECUs interconnected by CAN and LIN buses here. This enables us to do functional tests on distributed software systems in simulation. While this idea in itself is not completely new, we at dSPACE offer our VEOS ZIL simulation platform with access to the same comprehensive tool chain you know from rapid control prototyping and HIL testing. What you see here is a central gateway ECU, which is directly connected to the dashboard, and it's also communicating with a powertrain and gearbox system. It also forwards some information to the body ECU, and this is connected via LIN bus to the door modules left and right. So once we get in the car, we can, for example, open the door, see this directly in the dashboard while the doors are still unlocked, and we get closed, and now let's start the car. So get in gear, and once we go beyond 20 kilometers per hour, you will notice that the doors will lock. Ah, now they're locked. So this could all work, of course, with direct variable access between the ECUs. But I said we simulate the buses, so let's take a look at the bus communication. For that, I have a bus monitor open here, just from our control desk, and I can start the bus communication. So you see here the messages coming in. I would now like to take a look at the door ECU, at this door message, which will tell us more about the signals from open and closing the window. So, of course, I can sit here at the driver's seat and lower the window on the right-hand side, on the passenger side, and go up. And you will notice here how the data is going on and off. So at the same time, you can also analyze the bus statistics, like bus loads here in this instrument. So you see, in this simulation, we don't load the bus very much. So next, we can go on to testing, actual tests. And for that, I have installed a small switch here, which will disable the communication with the right door ECU. So once I open the switch, I can still open or close the window from my from my passenger side module. But the communication here from the left-hand side is gone. Also, you will notice that there is directly an errorless message here on this on the bus monitor. So, Martin, was that something you wanted to see?
Thanks, Gernot. That was exactly what I want to see. But let's talk about another example. As you may know, modern cars has a lot of sensors that are observing the surrounding of the car. These sensors are used for new functions like an adaptive velocity control, for example, or an emergency braking. And in the future, we would have even cars that can drive without a human driver inside. But of course, before these functions can be used in the real world, they have to be simulated first. So how can such a simulation environment can look like in the case of SIL testing? For example, you can use your system under test, in this case, a sensor fusion algorithm, maybe running on our tool that is called RTMaps. And this is connected to a VEOS system where the ASM traffic is simulated. And now, in addition to the example before, we have to simulate all these sensors, the radar, the camera, the LiDAR sensor, and so on. So this could be one example of a SIL setup. In a more complex example, you may want to use a complete virtual ECU, maybe even with adaptive AutoSAR content for sensor fusion and decision making. And to make it even more complex, it could be an example to have additional virtual ECUs and an ASM traffic running together on a VR simulation. So you see, depending what your test objectives are, there are several SIL testing setups possible. But Gernot, I think you have prepared an additional demonstration also for that type of testing, right?
Thank you, Martin. Indeed, I prepared an example here with an adaptive cruise control algorithm under test. You see it here installed in the blue car as it is facing a complex traffic situation that we simulate in the dSPACE ASM models. Here, all the roads, scenery, and sensors are simulated. From these sensors, the algorithm receives the information that it needs to decide how to operate the gas pedal and the brakes. What I actually want to show now is how this works with test automation. And for that, I have already opened Automation Desk, our test execution software. Here I can start this test sequence that we've prepared and start the execution of this. I will call this coffee break today. And start the execution. The sequence will now initialize the test, put the car on the actual test track, and also start the captures and eventually come up with a result for the test. So here the vehicle is now initialized and you see it running. There it's approaching a queue behind a truck and there's one vehicle cutting into our lane. That brake is a bit close, I think. And we see the result has failed. So let's see if we can improve the situation. So we have a calibration parameter here. Let's see if I can find a better value, maybe. And now we can already start the test sequence again and repeat the same test. Here we are again approaching the line. The cut-in occurs. Ah, this is a much safer situation. Martin, is this what you wanted to see?
Thanks, Gerald. Very impressive demonstration. Thank you very much. So let me summarize what we have seen so far. We have seen that we can generate virtual ECUs on different abstraction levels. We have seen our ASM models that can be connected to these virtual ECUs. And in case you have to simulate several ECUs that communicate together, we can simulate a bus simulation. All these components can be combined together on our simulation platform, VEOS, which can run on a Windows PC, a Linux PC, or even within the cloud. And if necessary, you can add your own models or your own testing tools to our environment, because we provide special interfaces like function mockup interface, XIL API, or whatever. This environment can now be used for either using in a requirements-based testing, for example, for tests, something like powertrain, brake systems, and so on, or you can use it within a scenario-based testing for autonomous driving. Well, here, because of the time, we cannot go into all that details, of course. So if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact us. Our experts can help you to find the right abstraction layer for your simulation, setting up your SIL environment and get it run. So please, let us be your partner for simulation and validation. Thank you very much and bye-bye.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.